I'm just going to take a few minutes to show you how I do a fretboard. The fretboards are made from scratch in a lot of cases. Sometimes you have to buy blanks. Like, you can't buy rosewood lumber, you can't buy ebony lumber. So I buy rosewood and ebony fretboards, kind of rough cut. So they're a little more than 1/4 inch. They're not jointed or planed. They're probably about 3 inches wide or so, and about just a little longer than a regular fretboard by a few inches. So they had to be flattened on a jointer, and then they have to be planed to get them to 1/4 inch thickness. Okay, so, and then of course they had to be on the table saw. They had to be cut off just a little more than 2 1/4 inch width. This piece of wenge was cut from lumber, so that was band sawed out rough and then jointed, planed, and then to thickness, 1/4 inch, and then, you know, right now it's probably 2.5 inches wide. It has to be trimmed in a little closer. But anyway, once that's done and the fretboard is prepared, like this piece of palfrero, okay, that was cut from lumber as well. I use this template to cut the fret slots. All right, so this is a steel template, and it's notched on the side. You can see these notches here. This side here corresponds to, you know, fender frets, standard frets, distanced for 25.5 inch scale length. So the scale length is the distance from the nut to the bridge, right, or to the saddle, approximately. But anyway, the frets are, or the fret slots are spaced for a 25.5 inch scale. Okay. Now, what I do here, I take the fretboard and I double stick tape it down to this template, okay? So I use this double stick tape, put it down here, and stick the fretboard on so it's secure, all right? And then we'll take it over to the table saw, and I'll show you what happens next. The fretboard is flattened on this. I have a bench top jointer here, which is 6 inches wide, so there's a spinning blade right here, okay, and two flat parallel surfaces. So basically you adjust the surfaces so that they're a little bit off of each other, okay, so that when you pass your workpiece over the blade, you flatten it. So this surface plane and that surface plane are not exactly, you know, matching up. You put the planes off of each other by, you know, a very small amount. And then when you pass your workpiece over the blade, it flattens that side, right? You take it then and bring it over to that yellow machine as a planer. You put the flat side down, the blades and the planer are on top. They cut the top surface. You put the flat side down, the jointed side of your workpiece, okay? Run it through the planer and then, you know, thickness it down to 1/4 inch. What you end up with then are two parallel surfaces and 1/4 inch thickness in the middle, or whatever thickness you want. You know, that big wheel on the side of the planer adjusts the distance that you want to, the thickness that you want, you know. So that's how the fretboard is prepared before the slots are put in. Okay, so we're at the table saw here. This is the regular table saw. Well, this is a fine cut table saw blade. It's 80 teeth per inch. I use it for, you know, making most of my cuts. This blade here is for cutting fret slots, and it's a very thin kerf. The kerf on this blade is probably close to 1/16 inch, right? The kerf on this blade is 20/1000 inch, all right? It's thicker here because you can't have a thin blade 20/1000 all the way through. It'd be too floppy. But just on the outside edge, in about, you know, 3/8 inch or so, it's 20/1000. And then beyond that, it's 50/1000. Okay, so that will make it fairly stiff. So that this blade goes on in place of this one. So I just swap the blades out. And fasten this in place. Just takes a second here. And this is the table saw as you'd buy it, like most people would know a table saw this way. But I have made this cross-cut sled, okay? Which goes on like that, and it's for making cross-cuts, okay? So it's just exactly what it says, okay? So it's a table saw, you know, it's mostly for ripping. If you want to make a cross-cut, you generally use another saw, like a miter saw or a band saw, not usually a table saw. It's a little bit dangerous, right? Unless you got something like this. If you want to make a cross cut now, you take your piece of wood. I have this square to the saw, okay, the way it was built. It's on rails, it slides in the slots here. And you make your cross cut like that. And it's very good, actually, because you can put a block in here, clamp it, and repeat the same cut over and over if you're making something, you know, pieces that had to be exactly the same length. But anyway, what we're doing now is making fret slots, okay? So this little saw here, I bring it up just above the sled, okay? And that distance above the sled here will be the depth of the fret slot, okay? So I cut a few slots on a piece of scrap wood like this, and then I use this gauge to test the depth of the slot. So for a 10-inch radius, I'd use this side of the gauge, put it in the slot until the line, the black line on that side is just hidden, okay? And then you know that the slot is deep enough. So you'd leave your blade at that distance. I have a nail put here, okay? And the purpose of that is to take it basically hooks into these notches on the template, okay? So the fretboard is secured onto one side with double stick tape. The template goes here, goes in the notch like that, okay? You push it across the saw. You push the fretboard across the saw, make your cut, okay? Come back, go to the next notch, push it across the saw, and so on, all the way up, okay? And then in the end, what you're left with when you take the fretboard off the template is a slotted fretboard. And the distances are exactly the distances on the template, and you don't have to do any measuring, okay? If you do measure, you always have to measure from the nut. Like, you know, you'll get the distances between each fret. There's charts for that. But it's always important to make the measurement from the same spot every time. So you'll get a measurement for fret one, you mark it, make a cut. Don't measure from one to two. Measure from the nut again to two. Okay? Measure from the nut to three, from the nut to four. If you measure from, you know, the next fret to the next fret, you increase the error every time. So there's a little bit of error in your measurement because, you know, the measurements are in thousands. So obviously you can't make a cut that precise by hand. You can get it pretty close, but, you know, it might be plus or minus a few thousands. But if it's plus or minus a few thousands from a fret that was already plus or minus a few thousands, you're going to increase the error. By the time you get down here, you're going to have, your frets are going to be off, and you won't be able to intonate the guitar. So you always measure from the nut. With this thing, however, you don't have to do any measuring. You just tape the fretboard blank on, and got your pin there, and you just move along the slots, okay? That's how you do it. Simple, right?